That's true. That's true. Yeah.
Banners really help a lot. Even the 6 foot one or 4 foot one.
All right.
Well, apparently they've decided they're not going to do anything.
Do I have him on camera? That guy in the white shirt? I'm taping right now. I got him on camera. All right, folks, get out your cameras.
This is at Walmart.
Get out your cameras.
By Highway 30 in Cockleville. Looks like the manager is coming over to talk to some people. I don't know what it could possibly be about.
What do you think we're doing?
Needing pictures of him, don't we?
Well, we have
the only people that get full time are the employees that use the work at night. The stock. And that's because they are really needed, like 11 to 7. And they are gone. But the other employees are really getting sliced.
But we're cool otherwise, right?
That's a matter.
Why don't you don't pass up the pamphlet?
back now to Walmart. The world's largest retailer is facing serious
problems. Yeah, we don't want to disrupt anybody. And we've been very, very careful to not disrupt anybody. I mean, I think you should.
I don't know. I mean, I can probably hear myself talk right now.
Can you turn that down now? That is loud.
Yeah, can we turn the volume down? Yeah, turn the volume down. Yeah, you're
I'll let this go on, but once it starts affecting what I need to do, then it's a whole different conversation, okay?
And you're, discussion. It's a little loud. Yeah, we're just trying to get a message out. We're not trying to disrupt anything. And so if anybody has disrupted, or if anybody's disrupted an associate working or a customer trying to shop, like, I want to know about it, because, like, that's not what we're about.
Okay.
So, has anybody said anything about, like, people being disrupted?
Yes.
I mean, other than the sound.
Yes, that's how I found out about one of our associates came in.
You know what? He's calling right now. Let me check. Hey, this is Kevin.
Well, it's nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Okay, all right.
Do we have any members at this time?
I'm not sure. I'm not over
there. Yeah, so we're just talking to to OJ, the co-manager of the store right now.
And it's, how are you doing today?
I'm doing fantastic.
So we were showing a video on the side of the building, and just playing some sound. So he's just come out, he's just turned the sound down, and he asked the cop that's so we went ahead and did that. So until you called, we were talking to the co-manager, but he just stepped away from the phone himself. So I really don't know where things stand. He's asked us to leave, and we're just trying to get in compliance. It sounds like the big issue was with the sound and the fact that we were passing stuff out. And he said that people have been disrupting customers, but he hasn't had a concrete example of that. So I want to make sure our people are behaving and aren't doing anything wrong. So.
It's affecting our community.
Okay.
It's not so much the pain. It's the respect. I respect you, you respect me. Having that respect, it's free.
Yep. All right. Cool.
It's been free.
So that was our goal. He said that it's... So... Right, I mean, you said that Walmart. Absolutely. Sorry about that.
Block this right here.
Yeah, sorry about that.
Don't want somebody to get run over.
Absolutely not.
A traffic cop is doing his duty. Thank you, sir.
So, you know, he said that you know, as far as Walmart policy went, we weren't, we didn't understand how that necessarily applied. But we're out here with a committee of folks. I'm sure you're familiar with the organization United for Respect at Walmart. Some of your associates belong to it, and associates all over the country.
Mm-hmm.
And so we want to confer with them, and then we can decide what to do. So that'll take about 5 minutes. If we can get together and talk about it and make a decision, and can we get back to you in 5 minutes then?
5 minutes? I will be hanging outside, okay?
Oh, perfect.
All right.
Thank you. So our Walmart members,
So, well, I've got other jobs, different ones.
I'm running out.